y'all don't mind, let's go back to a time when we really used to have church. We used to have a good time, praising the Lord, in spirit and in truth.
I love them old
said old brother,
song.
Pick up that old hymn book and
singing
you knew exactly what he was going to say. Sisters got happy, folks start patting their feet, clapping their hands, and all of a sudden he break off in a song, something like this.
Give God praise and glory to whom it belongs forever.
Yes,
amen.
I come to you by way of the Uptown Church of Christ.
Thank you, Lord.
You have no idea how good it is just to assemble. As David said, I was glad when I came to the house of the Lord. It's good to assemble with folk who are longing for Christ.
Yes.
Good to feel comfortable.
Yeah.
Among folk who identify themselves as Christians.
Yes.
It's a good thing to know that the blood of Jesus has covered us.
Yes.
In spite of us.
Yes.
Regardless of our slip ups and mess ups, I learned that he's all right.
Yeah.
It's good to know that the political genre of men has no power in the house of God.
Yes, sir. Uh-huh.
It's good to have a friend like your preacher, Brother Preacher. He's been a comfort and a security to me and my family through the course of many long and hard arduous journeys.
Oh, yeah.
Yet, the word and the foundation of God said it's sure.
Yes, sir.
Heaven is sealed.
Yeah.
Those of us who know the Lord, I call on God.
Yeah.
I say amen. Yeah. I don't care how hard times you get in your house, how many battles you go through, I don't care how what the devil do, you ought to call on the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
Every opportunity that you have.
Yeah.
Every now and again when you're driving and you find out some ridiculous thing is happening, you ought to shout, thank you, Jesus.
Yeah.
Every now and again when you up at night, can't sleep, you ought to just say, glory.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. I shall not. We have to. We must come to a place, church, where we are no longer moved by the silliness and immaturity of people who really don't know God. We have to come to a place that we realize that our master is returning soon. Oh yeah, he's coming back for those who know him and have loved him. He's coming back for those who have laid down their life for him. Coming back for those who have fought a good fight. And I don't know about you, but every now and again when I get caught up in the quagmire of foolishness and silliness, I just remember he's coming back again. This end in which turmoil and foolishness have eased its way into the Church of Christ at Corinth. It is this place where we find that there was infighting and there was arguments and fussing and even the men who wanted to have his father's wife.
Yeah.
We find in this text that there was even a battle over position, authority, and power.
Yeah.
Paul says, I got the information from the house of Corinth.
Yes.
When I got the information, I found sometimes it was hard to believe, but I'm hard to believe it because I know some of y'all.
Well,
I know that we can act up in the house of God. I know that church ain't nothing but a thing. Y'all want to say
amen?
But then he begins a difference.
In which he begins to explain to them that there's a difference in church folk and spiritual folk.
Right.
Come with me, if you will, as we explore the difference in somebody who has the Spirit and somebody who is led by the Spirit. Yes, we all receive it. Y'all want to say amen? We all receive the gift of the Holy Spirit.
Yes,
I believe that God kept his word when God said that if you repent and be baptized, I will give you the gift of the Holy Spirit. But the promise is not unto you alone, but to you and all your children that shall come. But everybody that got the Spirit are not led by the Spirit. And so it's good that when you come into the house, even now, that's like the church of Corinth, that you meet some folk who are led by the Spirit. something. He said, God, I'm in my text now, I'm verse number 10. God has revealed it unto us.
Yes, sir.
God has revealed his spirit unto us.
Yes, he has.
Now watch this. He says, that for what knoweth of me? Who knoweth of me? Save the spirit that's in me.
That's right.
You know what most of our problem is? We're trying to know what God knows.
Yeah. Come on now.
Yeah. And we find ourselves labeling and judging and messing with stuff that we ought not mess with. And even the man himself don't know himself like he thinks he knows himself. But the Bible says it's the spirit of God that's in the man. Not a man that has the spirit needs to know he has a spirit in him that knows him better than he knows himself.
Come on, Virgil. Take it.
Come on, Virgil. And not only does he know you better than you know yourself, he knows the deep things. The Bible says, the deep stuff about you. Y'all want to shout at me?
Amen.
You can handle what God knows about me, but I can't handle what God knows about you. Hey, bro. his natural self and gave a carnal answer to a spiritual prophecy. It had been prophesied that he would be betrayed. But he would have received the same saving grace that God gave each one of us had he just repented of his sin and did right. Why? Because God don't have to explain nothing to you.
That's right.
Thank you, Lord.
He'll have what? Mercy.
Mercy.
Now I don't understand why God forgave you. I don't know why he forgave me. But I'm thankful he had mercy. The King James Version says by verse 20, how in the world can the thing formed, and I don't care what you're going through in 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verses 10 through 14, because there's a whole lot of crazy stuff going on in the church.
Yeah.
How the church gonna look at me and say, I'm gonna quit the church? How the thing gonna look at me and say, why am I going through this? How am I gonna look at what I'm going through and act like God don't have all power? He says in verse 20, how does a thing fall? Satan who formed him, why has thou made me? Shall a thing form rebel against God? It'll rebel against God if it don't have the spirit of God in it. If you're not spiritual, you can't go through nothing. If you can't go through nothing, you can't get nothing from God. You gotta go through it to get to it. As long as you trust that what you're going through, God will make it.
Thank you.
All right. Okay. All right. So these are stuff that are out of my control.
That's
but
right.
Whose control? God's control.
That's right.
Now watch this. Spiritual folk compare spiritual things to what? Spiritual, according to the text.
That's right.
The carnal man cannot receive spiritual things. Some of y'all can't go through nothing because it takes a certain spirit to be lied on, talked about, and ridiculed. Some of you can't stand a little pressure from the other side. Why? Because it's foolishness to let somebody talk about your mama then. And you can say, I pray for when I'm in my natural self, you better let me alone.
Watch it, man.
Because I can't even hear James, Pete, and Paul.
No.
Not in my natural self.
That's right.
Because I'm not in my spiritual self.
Come on, man.
And in my natural self. Where does this stuff come from? Where does this anger? Well, when a person doesn't have the Spirit of God, the person then begins to resist anything that God puts before him.
That's right.
Verse 14 said his spirit cannot discern the things of God, for they are spiritually discerned.
Uh-huh.
And since they are spiritually discerned, there's a disconnect in what God is allowing to happen in your life and how you respond to what is taking place in your life. Sometimes you're speaking against something when you ought to be praying, thanking God for it, because it's the very thing you want to do, God's going to use in your life. Problem. And this is not your preacher, because your preacher, he schooled me on the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
He's absolutely right.
Amen.
Come on.
We spent years in the Church of Christ.
Come on, preacher.
Not connected to the Spirit of God.
Right.
But in the Church of God.
Amen.
Come on now.
Yeah.
We came to church, and some of you have been taught to robotically serve God.
Yes.
is a brief synopsis that also encompasses the work of God.
Yeah.
Going back to verse number 10, he says that he has revealed it unto us. For what knoweth a man? Number one, we realize that the spiritual God has a personal work in the man.
Yes.
It is the spirit. He said, likewise, or even though, he said, no man knows the what? The spirit of God.
Yeah.
Now, he didn't say the spirit of God that's in God.
Uh-huh.
But God is spirit.
Yes.
I don't know what's in the mind of God.
Right.
But I trust God.
Yes.
And just as I don't know what's in God's mind, what I do know is the spirit that God put in me.
Yes.
Trust God to lead me through to the other side.
Yes.
Come on now.
Yes.
We learn then, therefore, that he used a very emotional word.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, even the deep things.
Mm-hmm.
Deep is an emotional word, even for us. And in that language, am I right about it?
Yeah.
And so then we know that God's Holy Spirit works personally with us.
You,
it works emotionally with us.
Yes.
It works in our feelings. And it works in our experience.
Yes.
Well, I want you to give us a Bible for that, because you said that. I want you to give us a Bible for that. I wish I had my phone turned just a little bit. I ain't gonna, the devil ain't gonna get mad.
It's y'all
turn around. Just a little bit.
It's great.
Okay, where's my voice? That's why I can't preach.
All
right, text off. Are y'all there?
Yeah.
All right, now watch this. Watch the Holy Spirit work.
Come on,
y'all. Watch the Holy Spirit work.
Come on.
Watch this. I said the Holy Spirit has an effect on our spirit.
Right.
It is not just the word of God.
Yes.
Why did Paul say to Timothy? He said, Timothy, in 2 Timothy 1, verse number 6, I need you to stir up the gift. The word stir in the Greek literally means to kindle. It means to set on fire.
Yeah.
It means to rile up the spirit.
Yeah.
You know what you were doing this morning while we were serving? You were riling up the spirit.
Yeah.
You were, I was down when I came in here. Now I've got to sing it. And you stirred up my spirit. I don't even want to look at my lesson. I just want to preach till next night. And you can't connect to where you are spiritually. You either your natural self or your spiritual self. Can I get five people that stand up in the spirit to stand up and shout, thank you, Jesus, right here. Thank you, Jesus. Keep praying.
amongst you. But it also works in your life to assure you that when you are desolate and when you are quiet, that we have a Savior to call upon.
Yes.
I don't care about you, but I'm not going to. One thing the devil will never do to me.
Come on.
The devil will never shut me up.
That's it.
He will never shut me back. And I'll never let him shut me up. And if you came to church this morning and you sent me and you sent the identification of Psalms 143 and verse 4, my soul is quiet within me.
Yes.
My spirit is desolate.
Yes.
You ought to stand up right now and shout Luke 19 this morning. For me should hold their peace up. The rocks will immediately cry out.
Yeah.
Jesus.